you know, on bird migration, because that's clearly, I think having, standing out at the front probably provides some value and is good for education, if folks are comfortable with that.
And I think, Andy's original suggestion, what I heard was sort of in a generic context, just that there are other agencies and other units of government that do regulate aspects of wind sighting. And so I, that's what I heard your suggestion as for a guiding principle.
Correct.
So something along the lines of, we recognize that there are other government agencies who have a role, specific role and responsibility in sighting decisions. And we will be mindful to not go, you know, cross over into their responsibility as we go forward, or something like that. Is that?
That's fine, yeah. And pull out meeting notes again at the next meeting, because we do a little work.
Look at it, okay. Okay, any other thoughts or about the framework of sort of how we organize ourselves?
One other, Dan, you may have mentioned first thing, or someone else might have, being cognizant of the size of the project to which certain standards apply. I don't have a number to recommend, but as I can see certain studies, for example, when we propose, you know, dozens of turbines, it certainly makes sense to do certain very detailed assessments. For someone who wants to put up a single turbine in a community, and in their community, I don't know that the cost or the benefit are there. So the principle isn't as much a hard line as much as we'll be conscious of the requirement by size of the project.
But we do have that. We will have sort of at some point we'll have a conversation about defining a small project and creating a, perhaps a different, that's envisioned, correct?
And that's the last bullet at the bottom of the page.
Okay.
Refers to that.
Michael?
Yeah, Andy was actually talking about a small collection of large turbines as opposed to a small turbine. And I think we need to keep those boundaries fluid demarcated.
Okay.
I would suggest that both of those concepts should be discussed,
mm-hmm.
and maybe together, maybe separately, maybe both. But at this point, you know, there's no clear lines there. So whether small means small turbine, or there's a different category of small or number of turbines that are larger, I think both of those have yet to be discussed and should be discussed.
Okay. And then I want to sort of throw out one idea about sort of mode of operation. And this is, I'm sort of drawing upon both one and four when I make the suggestion, is that as a group, I think there will be a large percentage of our discussion which we will be able to quickly reach consensus. There will be a large number of the issues that the commission is looking for our guidance on that we will, you know, be able to work through and arrive at a consensus pretty quickly. So, and then I think there will be some issues, a much smaller number, which will generate some difference of opinion around this table. And what I'd like to suggest for this group is that we first focus on, in both of the subcategories that we're gonna be getting into, we try to sort of charge through and develop the consensus on those things that we can, and then note those that are generating more conversation and more discussion, and we sort of put those to the side. And I suggest that for two reasons. One is to allow us to, you know, I think it will be efficient for us to work through the significant number of specific things that we're being asked to opine on. And you know, sort of get those done quick, and then to identify those areas that are gonna generate some more discussion. And I also suggest that because I think, as we talked about in the last meeting, we will also want to develop maybe some special meetings that are not currently on, schedule some special meetings that are not currently on the agenda around specific topics and invite experts in. And I think by going through the, you know, going through the whole list first, identifying those things, good consensus on these. Here are the three or four or five areas where we're gonna need some more time, and we're gonna need to consult with some experts. Let's identify those, let's schedule, you know, with appropriate time out in the future, let's schedule some special meetings on those topics. And I think that way we can, you know, sort of, it helps us to identify those areas where we disagree, but it also allows us to work together and develop consensus on those issues that, you know, there will be, I think, pretty strong consensus around the group. So I'm just sort of throw that out there and see if people have reaction, like that approach, or not.
Yeah, as we think about the term consensus, and what is that going to look like? And one of the things about creating rules is, as I understand, there's the law, and then there's going to be the rules, which are how the laws can be implemented. And one of the things that comes up in promulgating rules is, where did the rulemakers change the law? And our rule right here, as far as consensus, one of the guiding principles might be, what does the law say?
And we're not going to change the law.
Right, exactly. I think where we get away from consensus is where we might lose track of the fact that we're not here to change the law. And keeping, sometimes, well, the reason there are rules is to interpret the law, and we may need to have input from some legal folks.
And policy experts.
And policy experts.
Right. No, I think that's a good point, and I think we should add that we're not here to change the law. I think that's a good foundation for us. We don't want to go off and try to, you know, subvert what the legislature has already decided on. But I think, Tom, where I envision there being some issues that are really in sort of the rule interpretation phase, which will generate some controversy, and that there could be two people around the table who have very different views of how to interpret that. And those are the ones that I'm asking this group to sort of set aside so that we can develop a strategy as a group for addressing that issue, deciding if we need to bring in additional experts or if we just need to take more time as a group to sort of walk through the issue. But certainly, I agree with you. We should not be, you know, as a group, we shouldn't be debating the law. We shouldn't be debating whether they made the right decision or not. And we can probably, all of us probably have opinions about whether they arrived at the right point. But that's really not our job here today. Michael?
And Mike, I might suggest, just so we know whether we might actually get to the close to changing the law, that we have a copy of the law that was changed and what was changed and what wasn't changed. And I think that would be very valuable to this discussion.
Yeah, I think we'll always have the law close to our best. Any other thoughts, suggestions, any concerns about sort of the process and how we're going to organize ourselves that you want to put on the table at this point? Okay. Then I'm going to ask Deborah, I didn't tell you this, but I asked the commission staff to take a look at the specific, and remember we divided our review, just for efficiency's sake, into two aspects. One is sort of the developer-owner responsibilities, and as I understand the process, we're going to see the draft rule first, covering those issues from the commission. And so I asked staff to develop this list or some suggestions for us to think about as far as guiding principles for developer and owner responsibilities. And they have done that, and that's what's on this page. And then next week, we're going to talk through the guiding principles on the siting and what's the other aspect?
The local and commission process.
And local and commission process.